Good evening, friends. Welcome to Durgasoft online training and welcome to a new course that is logic based programming. That is, here completely you can concentrate on programming area. So how to develop a logic, with that logic how you can write the program, so how you can implement the program in different programming languages. So all these things we are going to cover. So myself, Prakash Babu, having 13 years of experience. The course name is nothing but logic based programming, and the duration. No. That part we will discuss later. Please wait. So the duration of the course is 2 months. Okay. The programs are nothing but almost 400 programs we are going to discuss on this particular environment. So the timings are from 5 p.m. to 6 p.m. That is only from Monday to Friday. Saturday and Sunday, there won't be any classes. And the fee for this is nothing but 999. Okay. So you need to contact these numbers for registration purpose. 8096-969696, 9246-212143. So here, in addition to this, you are going to get running notes. Okay. Running notes, which contains all your programs and logic explanation, everything will be typed and it is going to be shared. And along with this, you are going to get video recordings with 6 months access. Okay, then, sir, coming to the syllabus, this is nothing but a tentative syllabus. On fly, I may add some more topics. Okay. These are the syllabus: programming basics, control flow statements related programs, arrays related programs, matrix related programs, strings. Majority of the programs will be covered on strings. And then how you can perform various operations on numbers. So how you can solve some kind of equations by using this programming, and how you can implement searching algorithms, sorting algorithms, mathematical related functionalities, data structures, how to prepare the patterns like printing of stars, numbers, all these things, and how you can generate some kind of sequences. Okay. No. Complexities won't be discussed. So operators, operator related programs, algorithms. So all these things we are going to discover. Okay. These are nothing but a tentative syllabus. It is a programming course. Database won't be there here. Please make sure. And sir, while implementing the program with these logics, we are going to implement the programs in these three scenarios. That is, so we will write a program in C language, we will write a program in Java, and even we are going to write the program in Python also. Sir, totally here, there are 7 phases will be there. First, we are going to explore the problem statement. What is a given problem? Suppose if the problem is very complex, okay. So first we are going to see the problem statement, and then we are going to divide the problem into multiple pieces. Suppose if the problem is a very complex, we can divide that problem into multiple pieces, and we are going to implement logic for these subproblems. Later, we are going to implement the divided logics into C language program, and then same thing we will implement in Java, and even in the Python also we are going to implement. Sir, here you can observe what is the difference, how the programming will be, what functionalities are then with respect to the programming languages. Sir, something like you can find a difference between these languages. Okay, then, sir, almost we have some test cases are there. Minimum 6 test cases will be there. Maximum you can expect anything. Okay, and all these programs, suppose if I'm explaining sum of even numbers program. Assume I have a number is there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like this. So my requirement is I want to calculate a sum of all these digits. For example, 1 + 2 + 3 + 4 + 5. Like this, if I'm calculating sum of digits, we will get the result 15. For this, I will explain. But similar to this, there will be another program will be there. That is, in this, you need to add only sum of even digits. You need to add only sum of even digits. Similarly, for the same number, you can implement the program to perform sum of odd digits. That means 1 + 3 + 5. like this you can implement the program. So such type of things I want to cover. Just these programs will be there in the hacker rank. That's why I have given 500. So maximum we will cover 400 programs on live. Some homework programs will be there in this hacker rank link, so you can able to solve. Suppose if you are getting any problem, with respect to this, then you can share that program. We will discuss in our class lively. Okay, this is nothing but our main agenda of the course. And here you can expect in the running notes these four parts. Okay, the first one is nothing but logic. And the second one is, sir, once if the logic is very clear, how you are going to implement in C language? Okay, how you are going to implement the same logic in C language? Slowly we will convert a program into C. Okay. Yeah, then same code we are going to implement even in Java also. And the same code we are going to write in Python also. So these four things you can expect in the running notes. That is logic, C language implementation, Java programming implementation, Python code also. Okay. Yeah. Sir, any doubts up to this? Please confirm. If everything is okay, we will start the session. Any disturbance from my side? Yeah, please confirm. I hope some people are raising voice issue. Please confirm. Is it clear? Yeah, please check it once. Voice is clear. Yeah, yeah, you can check it once. Hope the problem is from your side. The voice is very clear. Yeah, yeah, please check it once. Let me check from my side. Okay. Yeah, yeah. Okay, shall we start? Now I think my voice is clear now, right? Shall we start the first program? Yes, very good. So in our logic-based programming, sir, I'm going to explain the first program for you people. Logic-based programming, sir, 0001. First problem we are going to discuss. Sir, what is the problem statement? So slowly, we are going to start from basic first program to high level. Okay, every day we are going to cover minimum 5 to 6 programs. In that, 3 programs will be very easy, 2 programs will be very tough. Okay, one is moderate program. Like this, we are going to plan. So in today's session, our first program is nothing but I need to implement a program. Sir, to check whether the given number is even or odd number. This is my requirement. So we need to check whether the given number is even number or odd number. Sir, what are the inputs for this program? Sir, very simple. Here you need to accept a number from the user. What is the output of this program is nothing but, I mean, this statement, problem statement output is nothing but you need to print either even or odd. Sir, here you need to print one more constraint also. That is nothing but, suppose if the given number is a negative number, you need to print a statement called invalid number. Okay, then sir, is there any constraint for this program? Yes, we have a constraint is there. That is, the number must be always greater than or equal to 0. This is the constraint. Listen a bit carefully. What is a problem statement? We need to check whether the given number is even number or odd number. So input is nothing but, first you need to accept a number from the user. Once if you accept a number, then you need to implement the logic. That logic has to produce 3 outputs. One is even, or second one is odd, or third one is invalid. So these selection of these 3 statements is always depending on the number. Okay. And what is a constraint? Your number should be always greater than or equal to 0. Suppose if you are giving any number which is less than 0, then you need to get this message, which is nothing but invalid. So for this program, okay, constraint means condition. So for this program, you need to implement the logic. Sir, now my query is, can you please tell me, so what is the logic? What is the logic to check whether the given number is even number or not? Yes, can you please tell me how you can check whether the given number is even number or odd number? Suppose assume I'm giving a number called 5. So immediately from your side, you are going to get it is an odd number. How you can check? Very good, very good. Yeah, very good. So maximum correct answers. So if that number is divisible, if that number is divisible by 2, divisible by 2, then it is even number, else it is odd number. That's all. So first we need to check whether that number is divisible by 2 or not. If it is divisible by 2, then it is the even number, otherwise it is the odd number. Sir, let me explain with some small diagram. Suppose consider I am giving n is equal to 4. So if you divide 4 with 2, sir, 2s are 4, what about the remainder? 0. If you are getting remainder as a 0, then 4 is nothing but even number. Suppose consider n is equal to 5. So if you divide 5 with 2, so 2s are 4, the remainder is nothing but 1. If you are getting remainder as a 1, what is the meaning? It is nothing but odd number. So based on the number and if you divide with n, so based on the result, you can able to decide whether it is an even number or odd number. Now we need to implement a program for this in different programming languages. Sir, first I am going to write a C language code. How you can implement this program in C language? So for this, we have an online editor is there. In that online editor, I am doing the program. So here, the GCC compiler version is 9.1.0. And I will share this link also for you people. You can practice your C program, okay, here. So in our running notes itself, I am going to share all the links. So C compiler link, C online compiler link. So this is nothing but a C online compiler link, okay? Sir, here I'm going to type the program. What is a problem statement? You need to check whether the given number is even or odd. So here you can able to see the input is nothing but you need to accept a number from the user. So first we have to write a sample skeleton. I hope you know everyone how you can write the C program. This is the syntax of a structure of C program where main method will be there. The program execution always starts from main method. And here I declared one variable called n. So in this n only we are going to store the data. Then I am going to read the data directly from the user. Scanf percentage d ampersand n. So scanf is the statement which is used in C language to read a number from the user. And I am going to read integer type of data and I am going to store it in n. And if you want to make a decision, so in every programming language, we have a special condition is there, which is nothing but if. So if true means a true block, if false means a false block. So that means what? If the condition is a true, then it is going to execute this true block. Suppose if the condition is false, what will happen? It is going to enter into false block. So we need to prepare a condition such that which value we have to print. Sir, I am replacing this true block with even number. And I am going to replace this false block with odd number. And I am going to frame a condition. What is that condition? Already you told. If you divide n percentage 2, percentage division means it returns a remainder. If it is equal to 0, then it is nothing but even number. Suppose if it is not equal to 0, then it will become odd number. Like this, we need to implement the program. So first I am going to check the condition. If n percentage 2 is double equal to 0. So inside if statement, curly braces are optional. No need to take these curly braces if you are having only one statement. So curly braces are optional if we have only one statement. If you are having only one statement, then curly braces are optional. Suppose if you are having more than one statement, compulsory you have to enclose all these statements within this curly braces. Remember this point. So here I want to print only even number or odd number, only one statement, right? That's why I'm not using any curly brace, just to optimize my code. Okay. And here even number, I'm printing the message saying even number. Else, that means if the condition is not satisfied, I am printing the message saying odd number. The program is completed. Sir, in this editor, this is the recommended editor for doing C programs. In this editor, this is nothing but a program panel. Here you need to type the program. And here you have to supply your inputs for the program. And whatever command line arguments are there, you can supply from here. And this is nothing but output panel where you are going to see your output. So once if you click on this execute button, it will scan the total program. If there is no error for this input, what is your expected output that you are going to get here? So if it is a correct, then our logic is correct. If it is wrong, our logic is correct, wrong. Okay. So here, first I'm giving the number as a 5. Sir, check whether it is giving odd number or not. Yes, it is giving odd number. Let me take a 12. And check whether it is giving even number or not. Yes, perfectly it is giving. Let me give any negative value, minus 56 I am giving. So our expected answer is nothing but invalid. But what answer we are going to get? Even number. So they have given a constraint saying that, so here the input must be always greater than or equal to 0. If it is not greater than or equal to 0, then we have to print a message saying invalid. This we need to inject into your this particular program. So if some condition, then you need to execute this statement. Else we have to print a message saying invalid number. What condition we have to frame here? Sir, the value of n must be greater than or equal to 0. That's all. A simple program. Now you can check minus 56. If you execute, what answer we are going to get? Invalid number. This is the perfect logic. Once if you know the logic, if you implement that logic in any one program, sir, in the remaining programs, it is very easy. Sir, hope you got the clear point about this program. Sir, don't assume the programs will be like this. The programs are very hard programs we are going to take. But just as a beginning, we need to start with a small agenda, right? That is the reason why we have selected this program. But in future, every program includes this logic. So whenever you are taking the numbers, previously I said one example, right? So we need to take sum of digits. In these, you have to calculate sum of even digits. So in that cases, compulsory, you should know the logic, right? How you have to check the given digit is even digit or odd digit. For that, you must understand the logic. That is the reason the first program we are taking like this. Okay, sir, hope the concept is very clear for you people. Sir, do you have any doubts in this C language code? Yes, please, you can. Yes, please confirm. Any doubts? Yeah, I will explain about that return statement. Don't worry. Other than that, any doubt? Yes, fine. Very good. Yeah. Sir, you can able to see in C language, every function is going to return some value. Not only C language, everywhere compulsory the method or a function means compulsory it should return a value. But in the main method, generally we are going to take void main. So while writing the programs, maybe in your basics, you have seen by taking void main. But it is a good programming practice to make at is an integer main method. That means while developing this C programming language in the Unix operating system, the default return type for the main method is nothing but integer, not void. The default return type for main method is always integer. That is the reason it is a good programming practice. Even while you are writing, better to use the main method return type as integer. So because we are executing on online compilers, right? That may be the reason. And if it is returning integer, what is the meaning? Sir, on success, we are going to return 1. On failure, you are going to return 0. 0 means what? So false value. one means what true value. In the C language, we don't have any Boolean type, right? That is the reason we are depending on this 1 and 0. So that is the reason. Other than that, nothing. Even if you are not taking, some compilers will allow, but some compilers will give warning message, but there is no error. But it is a good programming practice to take integer main, and finally better to return a success message that is nothing but 1. Anyway, whether the program is correct or not, it is always depending on our code only. Clear? Yes, very good. Yeah, this is about the C code. Now, the same code I want to implement in Java. Yeah, any other number you can take. I want to implement the same code in Java. So I hope you know the skeleton of Java program. Okay, so this is the edit plus editor. Negative value also we can return. So in C language, 0 means false, non-zero means true. Please remember. So I'm going to use this edit plus editor where you can type your Java program. The default skeleton will be available as it is. Let us save this program in our working directory. I created a separate folder for this logic-based programming. Here I'm going to give the file name as a test.java. Make sure that whenever you are saving test.java, T must be capital letter. So naming conventions. In Java, every class name must begin with the test. Main method is will be there even in Java also, but the default skeleton for main method is like this. So here, what is your first duty? You need to read input from the user. Sir, if you want to read input from the user, we need to depend on one class, which is nothing but a scanner. Scanner obj is equal to new scanner of. Sir, here there are three resources are there for this scanner. If you want, you can read from input device. If you want, you can read from a string. If you want, you can read from a file. So from these locations, you can able to scan the data. But in our programming, so we are always depending on input device. That's why I am removing these two. And the scanner class is not a default class. Like whatever we did in the C language, like include stdio.h, right? In the same way, here also, you have to import this particular scanner class because by default, it is not available. But how you can include this scanner class in Java, it will be depends on import statement. Import java.util package is there, dot scanner. Okay, there is one predefined package is there with name Java. Java, in that Java package, so we have a sub package, n number of sub packages are there. In that util is one of the sub package. So in that multiple classes are there. So one of the class is nothing but our scanner. I am importing this scanner class to my program. What, to what purpose? To read the data from the input device. So I hope the concept is very clear. So every time explanation is not required. Maybe from tomorrow, you can able to understand this line very well. So now, how many inputs you have to accept for this program? Only one input, right? So I'm taking like this integer, the number n is equal to obj.nextInt. Okay, so obj.nextInt. So my n is available. Now you have to make a decision. Sir, first, if the condition is satisfied, one activity. If it is not satisfied, in Java, how you can print the message? By using system.out.println. Okay, invalid number, like this I am printing. Sir, when it is invalid, suppose if the value of n greater than or equal to 0 means we are doing some activity. If it is not greater than 0, then, sir, we have to print some activity. That activity is nothing but we need to check whether it is even number or odd number. Please, while class is going on, please listen the class. Then you can ask all your queries. Okay. Yeah, please wait. So if the number is greater than 0, then I am taking n percentage 2 is equal to 0. Already I explained this logic. system dot out dot println of sir even number. Yes, perfect. Else I am printing system dot out dot println of odd number. Yes, the logic is very clear for you people. Now my program is ready. Of course, the same logic only. Whatever I implemented in the C language, the same logic, but which is changing input and then output. At the end of the class, I will summarize IO statements in all these three languages. Don't worry. Now this program is ready. Now we need to execute this program. Sir, I already opened the command prompt, or let me open the command prompt freshly. This is nothing but my command prompt. From this only, I'm going to execute the programs. Sir, all our programs and running nodes, everything is available in the D drive. In the D drive, there is one special folder is there called Prakash classes. In this logic based programming, there is a folder is there. In this, I saved my test.java. Now you need to run from this. So D drive, cd space Prakash classes, cd space logic based programming. Here the tool which is used to compile your Java program is Java C space test.java. If you press enter, if you hit the enter button, then the program is going to compile. Compile means it will check is there any error in the program or not. So if there is no error, it returns to the next prompt. In my program, there is no error. Java space test, which is used to run your program. Once if you hit the enter button, it is waiting for input. Now you can supply your data. Sir, I'm giving -89. What is the expected answer? Invalid number. Run one more time. I'm giving the input as a 12, even number. Sir, let me execute second time. I'm giving 7. Answer is nothing but odd number. Okay. Sir, hope you got a clear clarity about how you can implement the same logic in Java programming. Sir, even for your sake, I will copy paste outputs also. Don't worry at all. Okay, now, sir, last language, which is nothing but Python. I want to implement this in Python programming. Sir, the easiest programming language is nothing but Python only. Now, in the same edit place, I am going for Python code. Python follows different kind of programming languages technique. It is a functional oriented, it is a object oriented, it is a scripting oriented. That is the reason it is not having any default skeleton. Now, directly you can read the input. N is equal to int of input. Here, whatever data you are reading in Python, it will be always in the form of strings. So manually, you need to convert it into integer. The reason for that is you are doing modulus operation, right? If you want to do modulus operation, it is possible only for the numbers. So if the input is a string, how you can do such type of operations? That's why our logic demands only integer value. I am trying to convert it into integer type. Then, so if n is greater than or equal to 0, boss, my n value is greater than or equal to 0. In Python, sir, we don't have any these brackets. Curly braces is not there. So to replace that, we have indentation is there. Sir, after writing if condition, so here if you are taking any statement within this particular line, then it is called as indentation. So my n is greater than 0 means we are going to write instructions later. If it is not greater than 0, just I am printing a message saying invalid. Suppose if it is greater than 0, then we need to make two decisions, that is whether it is even or odd. So if n percentage 2 is equal to 0, then we can print the message saying even number. Else we can print the message saying odd number. Yes, my program is ready. Curly braces, such a type of terminology is not there. Here you can able to see after typing this colon, if you press enter, it comes here. So from here, if you are taking, then it is called as indentation. For this if condition, this is the indentation. Like this, based on indentation, the flow of control will be. Sir, how you can execute Python program? It is not a compiler based programming language. It is interpreter. That means what? Directly you can run the program. I am taking py space file name. What is the file name? Test.py. Once if you press enter button, it is waiting for input. Assume I am giving 10. My answer is even number. I am giving 11. My answer is odd number. I am giving minus 13. The answer is invalid. Sir, hope the logic is very clear for you people. So how we got in different programming languages? The logic is the same, but which things are changing? Simple IO statements are changing. Sir, now my requirement is, so in C language, how to read input? How to read input? Very simple. So how you can read? By using scanf function. Sir, in Java, how to read the input? In Java, we can read the input by using scanner class. So in Python, how you can read the input? So we can read the input in Python by using which function? Input function. Similarly, in the C language, how you can print output? How I can print output? Very simple. For that, we have to go for printf. In Java, how you can print output on the screen? For this, we need to go for which statement? System.out.println. Sir, I want to print output on Python programming. I want to print output on Python programming. Very simple. We have a special function is there, which is nothing but a print. So these are the various techniques to read data from the user and to write data to the console. That is different programming languages with different approaches. Okay. Sir, hope the logic is very clear for you people, and even the program explanation is very clear with various inputs and then outputs. This is nothing but the first program what we have. Yes, now you can ask all your queries related to this program. Okay, is the video recording is available? Yes, video recording is going on. They will share the video, don't worry at all. And someone is telling, sir, I'm not getting that obj.nextint. Sir, very simple. obj.nextint, it is used to read integer value. What kind of value I'm reading? Integer value, right? That's why obj.nextint we have to read. So if you want to read floating point value, we have to use next float. If you want to read double value, we have to take next double. Like this, based on the data type, the functionality is changing. Sir, if you want, you can see the profile of that particular class. So Java P, Java dot, util dot, scanner class. If you press enter, it will display all the methods which we are associated with this. Okay, have a look once. Which method we used? Next int. Similarly, if you want to read long integer, this is the method. If you want to read floating point, this is the method. If you want to read double, this is the method. Like this, we have. If you want to read object, next. Sir, even big decimal you can able to read. So this is the term which is related to the Java. Forgot about that. Can we get help in the Edit Plus or Notepad? Yeah, better to use Edit Plus. That will be very flexible. Syntax highlighting will be there. Yes, yes. Lambda functions, all these things we are going to use. Sagar. Java P is a command which is used to see the profile of a particular class. Even if you want, you can see the profile of our created class, which is nothing but a test, which is having only two things. That is not in our scope. PowerShell, all these things are not in our scope. Yeah, one language is sufficient, but try to observe the things in different terminologies. What is DSA? Anand. That part I told, right? Only basics will be covered, not advanced. Okay, fine. Clear, right? Yes, all these programs, 300 plus programs in C, Java, and Python. 300 into 3, almost 900, 1000 programs we are going to get in this editor. situation demanded means we will handle the exceptions also, because today is the first class related to the programming. On Friday, just we started only introduction. Okay. Yes. And one more information, sir, here you can able to see this program is already dumped in one HackerRank website. You can able to open that website and try to do the program. Okay. The duration of this course is 2 months, 2 months. So what is it is http://www.sirhackerrank.com/LBP logic based programming test. Just press enter. It will ask to enter into the contest. Please sign up. If you have any Google account, you can communicate with the Google account. So here you are going to get challenges like this. Okay. You are going to get challenges like this. Just for your reference, I added only 2 challenges. Please try to solve this. So I'm clicking on the first challenge. So whatever program I explained, the same thing is there here. Program to check whether the given number is even number or odd number. Okay. The input is nothing but the number n, and the constraints are nothing but the value of n must be always greater than or equal to 0. And we have to get output as a even or odd or sometimes invalid. Sample input 12, then output should be even. Remember these words. So you should not take in the uppercase. Okay. If you are implementing by your own, then no problem. But when you are implementing in the online, challenges, coding challenges, then make sure that whatever they are expecting, you need to provide in this format only. The reason for that is they have dumped the test cases like that. Suppose if the input is a 13, you need to get odd. Only 2 test cases are visible for you people. Remaining test cases are hidden. Now, I enabled 3 different programming languages for you people. You can choose any one of the language. If you are interested in C, you can go with C. If you are interested in Java, you can go with Java. If you are interested in Python, you can go with Python. Okay, it is completely based on you. Let me take Java. Sir, here they are asking, enter your code here, read input from stdin. I told right from the input device only we are going to accept, and print output to stdout. Your class name should be always a solution. Yes, it is already there. No need to edit the class name, and required packages are already implemented. Now just you need to write the code. That's all. Okay. So just again, I am typing. Please don't mind. Scanner obj is equal to new scanner of system.in. my scanner got ready. Now you need to accept a number, obj.nextint. yes, my number is ready. Now first if condition we have to select, and if it is not satisfied, you need to print invalid, right? Invalid. Suppose if the condition is n greater than or equal to 0, then you have to check one more condition. If it is true, then I am printing system.out.println of even number. Suppose if it is not satisfied, then I am printing system.out.println of odd number. That's all. My program is ready. Just you can run the code. Yes, first test case is passed successfully. Second test case is passed successfully. Okay. STDIN means standard input device. So test case 2 is also clear. Now you can submit your code. Yes, you can submit your code. Code submitted. Okay. Sir, here there are some test cases. Score is 1.0. Status is accepted. Total almost 6 test cases are there. All the test cases got passed. Now you can see the leaderboard position. So someone is already doing. Okay, someone is already doing. Okay. Yes. Parth_995 user has completed. He got score 1. Parallelly, someone is doing. No problem. Okay. So like this, you can implement the program in that HackerRank link also. What is the URL for that? What is the URL for that? Just have a look once. One minute. Yes, I will type here. So https://www.sirhackerrank.com/ so logic based programming test. Sir, it is the temporary link. So once if the class is regularized, I will provide the original link. Don't worry. Okay. Just it is the temporary link. Hacker rank link. Hacker rank demo link. So even I am sharing this on your chat window. So please copy paste to your clipboard. Okay. We need to pass. Yeah, after passing those two sample test cases only, you have to submit. It is giving some kind of confirmation for you people. Once if it is clear, then you can submit the code. Otherwise, you should not submit. Clear? Sir, I hope with this, you got a clear clarity how our programming will be. Any doubts up to this? Yes. Like this, we are going to see maximum programs. Sir, it is a very simple program. Remember, just I have taken it as a very introduction program. Like this, we have n number of problems are there. Don't worry at all. Everything we are going to cover. So on daily basis, two programs will be low level programs, simple programs, one middle level program, okay, and one high level program. Those high level programs I collected from various MNC company testing rounds like Wipro, okay, IBM, okay, Accenture, and some interviews like Hacker Earth, Hacker Rank, Google, YouTube, such a type of questions also available with us. But to solve that, one complete session must be required. So such a type of programs we will discuss at the end of the course, so that even you will become very strong. If you practice these 400 programs, it's more than enough. You can go to anywhere and you can give left and right. Okay. The session timings are from, as usual, 5 to 6. Okay. Yes, any doubts up to this? Please confirm. Any doubts up to this? Yes. Yeah. Today is the first day, right? One more program we are going to try now. Don't worry. Yeah, Shyam, definitely, Shyam. Definitely, I will, Shyam. Don't worry. This is the mobile number for contacting admin people. New link, automatically you are going to get a new link once if the link is changed. Okay, don't worry. Yeah, no problem. Manikanta, okay, no problem. Yeah, this is the Python code. No, Pooja, no. Yes, Munir Basha, same energy will be there till the end. Edit Plus is there. You can download directly from the internet. Editplus.com is the website. Yeah, you can use anything for executing the program. No problem. No, no, no. We will allow mic also, but as of now the crowd is full, right? That's the reason. Munir Basha Parth already done the program. Very good. Okay. Sir, now just I will. Yeah, I will share. Don't worry. Sir, just I will give description of the second program. Okay. Sir, tomorrow we will solve that program. Okay, just I am going to provide description of the second program. Second program title and what the second program is going to do. Just have a look once. Yeah, this is our second problem. It is there in the HackerRank original website. So given an integer n, perform the following conditional actions. So if n is odd, that means if the n number is an odd number, then we have to print void. If n is even number, again there are three cases are there. If n is even and within the range of 2 to 5, within the range of 2 to 5, then you need to print not void. If n is even and in the inclusive range of 6 to 20, then we have to print void. If n is even and if it is greater than 20, you need to print not void and make sure that input is nothing but a number from the user and the constraint is nothing but 1 less than or equal to n less than or equal to 100 and output should be void or not void. Okay, so we will solve this program today, but this program is there in our HackerRank. You can practice if want. If anyone wants to try, yes, you can try that. Okay, just a matter of minute. I will show you that contest. Yes, you can able to see this is the challenge. Given an integer, perform the following conditional actions. Like this, you need to print. So anyway, some sample test cases are there. Programming language is also selected. You try to implement by your own. If not, anyway, tomorrow I will explain. Just reverse of this program. So first we have checked whether it is a positive number or not, right? In the same way, if it is a odd number, then you need to print directly void. If it is not odd number, such a type of if conditions you have to take in the else block, nothing more than that. Okay, so here you can able to see if the odd number means directly you can print. If it is not odd number, multiple if conditions you need to take. Sir, the same logic in C, Java and Python. Okay, sir, hope you can able to solve this problem. If not, tomorrow we will discuss. Don't worry at all. So today, just explanation, how to read the input for all these things. It is a time taken process. Okay. But from tomorrow, you know very well about scanner class, right? You know very well about object.int. You know about scan. You know about Python input technique so that we can run very fastly. Okay. Yeah. Yes, any doubts? Is it clear now, as of now? Yes. If you are having any queries, yes, please. Course fee, 999. Any other queries? Today's class file, just I am going to share a drive link. Just wait for a few minutes. Still that if you are having any queries, yes, please. Per day, 4 to 5 programs. It's a very small amount, Sairam. Even in this, you should not ask concession. And for to run this, 1 minute. Yeah. So to execute these or to run these programs, any one programming knowledge is sufficient. Okay. Yeah, yeah. So the drive link is shared in our chat window. You can download the current running notes from that. Okay. Yeah. So hope you enjoyed the session. We will meet for the continuation tomorrow. If any doubts is there, please let me know. Otherwise, we will close the session. Yes, yes, Sairam, correct. Clear, right? No doubts, please confirm. Yes, tomorrow same link. Tomorrow same link. Join 5 minutes before. We will exactly start at 5 o'clock. Hacker rank link that is there in the notes. You can able to open and you can see. Udayasri. Every program, yes, in 3 languages. Okay, no problem, Munir Basha. No issues. Yeah. Sir, thank you. We will meet for the continuation tomorrow. Thank you.